Hello and welcome back to Engineering Online. To establish a good communication between human world and machine world, display units play an important role. That is why they are an important part of embedded systems. In this tutorial, we are going to interface a 16x2 LCD with Arduino Uno. Unlike normal development boards, interfacing of LCD with Arduino is quite easy. Here we don't have to worry about data sending and data receiving. We just have to define the pin numbers and it will be ready to display data on LCD. LCD screen or liquid crystal display is an electronic display module and it is used in a wide range of applications. A 16x2 LCD display is quite basic module and is most commonly used in various devices and circuits. LCD is preferred over 7 segments and other multi-segment LEDs because LCD is quite economical and easily programmable, plus there is no limitation of displaying special and even custom characters, animations, etc. A 16x2 LCD means it can display 16 characters per line and there are two such lines. In this LCD, each character is displayed in 5x7 pixel matrix. There are a lot of combinations available like 8x1, 8x2, 10x2, 16x1, etc. But the most commonly used one is the 16x2 LCD. That is why we will continue with it. In 16x2 LCD, there are overall 16 pins if there is a backlight. If there is no backlight, then there will be 14 pins. One can power or leave the backlight pins. Now in the 14 pins, there are total 8 data pins, 2 power supply pins, 3rd pin for contrast control, and 3 control pins, that is register select, read write and enable. Pin 1 is VSS and it is connected to ground. Pin 2 is VDD and it is connected to 5 volts. Pin 3 is VEE, that is contrast control. VEE controls how thick the characters should be shown on the display. Pin 4 is register select. There are two types of registers, that is command register and data register. The command register stores the command instructions given to the LCD. A command is nothing but an instruction given to LCD to do a predefined task like initializing it, clearing its screen, setting the cursor position, controlling display, etc. The data register stores the data to be displayed on the LCD. The data is the ASCII value of the character to be displayed on the LCD. Select command register with low value and data register with high value. Then we have pin 5. Pin 5 is read or write enable pin. LCD itself consists of an interface IC. The microcontroller unit can either read or write to its interface IC. Most of the times we will be just writing to the IC since reading will make it more complex and such scenarios are very rare. So information like position of the cursor, status completion interrupts, etc. can be read if required, but it is out of the scope, so we will leave it. The contrast bit and read-write are not often used, so they can be shorted to the ground. This puts LCD in highest contrast and read mode. Pin 6 is enable pin. It sends data to data pins when a high to low pulse is given. We just need to control enable and RS pins to send characters and data accordingly. The LCD can work in two different modes, namely the 4-bit mode and 8-bit mode. In 4-bit mode, we send the data nibble by nibble, first the upper nibble and then lower nibble. For those of you who don't know what a nibble is nothing but a group of 4 bits. So the lower 4 bits D0 to D3 of a byte form the lower nibble, while the upper 4 bits, that is D4 to D7 of a byte, form the higher nibble. This enables us to send 8-bit data completely, whereas in 8-bit mode, we can send the 8-bit data directly in one strike since we can use all the 8-bit lines. Now you must have guessed it that 8-bit mode is faster and flawless as compared to 4-bit mode. But the major drawback is that it needs 8 data lines connected to the microcontroller. This will make us run out of I/O pins on a microcontroller unit. So 4-bit mode is widely used. No control pins are used to set these modes. Then we have pin 15 and 16. Pin 15 and 16 are the positive and negative connection of a backlight. So connect pin number 15 to positive 5 volts and connect pin number 16 to 0 volts. Then we have a connection diagram. Connect pin number 1 to ground, pin number 2 to 5 volts. Then connect pin number 3 to ground also. Then connect register select pin to pin number 12 of Arduino. Connect read write pin to ground. Connect enable pin to pin number 11 of Arduino. Now connect pin number 11, 12, 13 and 14 of LCD to pin number 5, 4, 3, 2 of Arduino Uno. In the end, connect pin number 15 to 5 volts and pin number 16 to ground. Once all the connections are completed, now we will implement the same logic on the hardware also. First of all, I will include the header for LCD, that is liquidcrystal.h. This header file has instructions written in it which enable the user to interface an LCD to Uno in 4-bit mode. With this header file, we don't need to send data to LCD bit by bit. This will all be taken care of and we don't have to write a program for sending data or command to LCD bit by bit. Then initialize the constants by associating LCD interface pins with Arduino pins like register select, EN, D4, D5, D6 and D7. In this instruction, we are going to tell the board where we have connected the pins. These pins are to be represented in the correct form. Then we have to tell the board that which type of LCD we are using here, since we have so many different type of LCDs like 20x4, 16x2, 16x1, etc. So here we are going to interface a 16x2 LCD. In this loop, initialize the cursor position from 0,0, that is 0th row and 0 column, and then write a string here using lcd.print command. Then change the position of cursor. And move to the first row and 0th column. And write another string here. Now add a delay of 1 second. And then repeat the same procedure after. In the result, you will see that two strings are appearing on the LCD with a delay of 1 second. Coding is almost done now. Now compile it and correct if there are any syntax errors. Upload the sketch on Arduino Uno and see the results. Okay, now try it on your own and provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. I hope that you must have learned a lot from this video. You can do many more exciting projects with LCD and Arduino Uno. That was all for today. Do like this video and share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Thank you.